Question 21. How does LTE UE positioning works in EUTRAN? Answer. UE positioning function is required to provide the mechanisms to support or assist the calculation of the geographical position of a UE. UE position knowledge can be used, for example, in support of radio resource management functions as well as location-based services for operators, subscribers, and third-party service providers. Question 22. How many operators have committed for LTE? Answer. List of operators committed for LTE has been compiled by 3G Americas from Informa Telecoms and Media and Public Announcements. It includes a variety of commitment levels including intentions to trial, deploy, migrate, etc. Question 23. What is single radio voice call continuity? SRVCC. Answer. Along with LTE introduction, 3GPP also standardized single radio voice call continuity, SRVCC, in release 8 specifications to provide seamless continuity when a new UE handovers from LTE coverage, EUTRAN, to UMTS/GSM coverage, UTRAN/GERAN. With SRVCC, calls are anchored in IMS network wide. While UE is capable of transmitting / receiving on only one of those access networks at a given time. Question 24. How does location service work in LTE network? Answer. In the LCS architecture, an evolved SMLC is directly attached to the MME. The objectives of this evolution is to support location of an IMS emergency call, avoid impacts to a location session due to an inter-e-node B handover, make use of an evolved and support mobile originated location request MOLR and mobile terminated location request MTLR services. Release 9 liters CS solution introduces new interfaces in the EPC, SLG between the GMLC and the MME, SLS between the ESMLC and the MME, diameter-based SLH between the HSS and the HGMLC. Question 25. How does lawful interception works in LTE Evolved Packet System? Answer. 3GPP Evolved Packet System, EPS, provides IP-based services. Hence, EPS is responsible only for IP layer interception of content of communication, CC, data. In addition to CC data, the lawful interception, LI, solution for EPS offers generation of intercept-related information, IRI, records from respective control plane, signaling, messages as well. Question 26. What is carrier aggregation in LTE Advanced? Answer. To meet LTE Advanced requirements, support of wider transmission bandwidths is required than the 20 MHz bandwidth specified in 3GPP Release 8.9. The preferred solution to this is carrier aggregation. It is of the most distinct features of 4G LTE Advanced. Carrier aggregation allows expansion of effective bandwidth delivered to a user terminal through concurrent utilization of radio resources across multiple carriers. Multiple component carriers are aggregated to form a larger overall transmission bandwidth. Question 27. What is relay node and how does relaying works in LTE Advanced? Answer. For efficient heterogeneous network planning, 3GPP LTE Advanced has introduced concept of relay nodes, RNs. The relay nodes are low-power e-node Bs that provide enhanced coverage and capacity at cell edges. One of the main benefits of relaying is to provide extended LTE coverage in targeted areas at low cost. The relay node is connected to the donor RNB, DENB. Via radio interface, UN, a modified version of EUTRAN air interface UU donor ENB also serves its own UE as usual, in addition to sharing its radio resources for relay nodes. Question 28. What are the measurement events in LTE? Answer. Intra/inter-frequency events. Event A1, serving becomes better than threshold. Event A2, serving becomes worse than threshold. Event A3, neighbor becomes offset better than P-cell. Event A4, neighbor becomes better than threshold. Event A5, P-cell becomes worse than threshold 1 and neighbor becomes better than threshold 2. Event A6, neighbor becomes offset better than S-cell. Inter-RAT event. Event B1, inter-RAT neighbor becomes better than threshold. Event B2, P-cell becomes worse than threshold 1 and inter-RAT neighbor becomes better than threshold 2. Question 29. When radio link failure is detected? Answer. Radio link failure to be detected upon T310 expiry upon random access problem indication from MAC while neither T300, T301, T304 nor T311 is running upon indication from RLC that the maximum number of retransmissions has been reached. Question 30. What is SRS used for? Answer. UL reference signal used to measure the channel quality over a section of the bandwidth. Node B uses this information for frequency selective scheduling and link adaptation decisions.